half of class. Thank you for everything. Bless our country. Bless this one of us. Thank you, God. Now slowly open your eyes. Many of you got distracted. Some of you have saw beauty color, pulling the hair, doing hair, keeping you straight. This is only 2 moments, not 2 minutes in case. Thank God. So what happens to us? All the tensions are out. All the cosmic energy is. Now, otherwise by the time, you know, when we become little older, by 10 standards, we all will be walking out from the school like this. So whenever you sit, you must try to sit comfortably. See, when your backbone is straight, the energy comes down straight. The blood flow is there. That will help you to keep you alert. The moment we are like this, suppose I sit and teach like this, what do you think? You feel awkward, no? No? Up and down. Buddha will be so happy, no? What dancing, drifting, all. Isn't it? But now God is allowing us to be little thankful. We are too old. Let us pass you on. If you want lessons, observe the lessons. If you don't want to observe, nobody bothers. Isn't it? Now teacher, the Bible said, children, my children, you all must study. This you must go, this must go. So it is because of that, no? Isn't it? So what is important? We are going to decide. We want to learn 6th standard nicely. Then we will go to the 6th standard. Now when you recall back 4th standard, what do you remember? Anything you remember? 4th standard? Hardly some classes you all had, something you all taught, something you all wrote, something you all... And in spite of that, what happened you all? You all read? Which class? 5th standard, whether you studied or not, you all went to 5th standard. Are you all feeling happy?
Yes.
Oh, but then you must remember, your 1st standard had nice foundation, 2nd standard had nice foundation, 3rd standard, nice foundation, the 4th below it is? Oh, because you all did not come to school. So now why we want at least that 4th standard? If there is one more nice pillar is given, what happens to the building? It becomes a storm, isn't it? That is why we are calling you all to the school. Otherwise now what will happen? June, July, August, September, October. Months will pass within no time. 5th standard also will finish and then you will go to the 5th standard high school. Till now you all are in the primary. So we treat you like a baby. Video. And so give you everything broken. But once you go to the 6th standard, you all are high school students. We treat you all like a leader. Because only one class ahead of you. So you all are second in command. So you all will become great leaders. How you all are coming up, like that the school will be. Because you all will put legacy for the school. So that is very important. Now, when we are taking, so any building we need what? What we need? From what? If suppose I have to build that building, what we need? What you need? Cement. Then? Brick. Then? Iron. Then? Soil is because we need. What else we need? stone. Then style. Then what else we need? Color. Furniture. So that you make. So building we need very strong. All this is there. Now suppose I put cement here, the bricks here, all that is I put everything, whatever you have said, it became building?
No.
No. Then what we need? It has to be proportion. So also with any language, whether it is Marathi, whether it is French, whether it is Hindi, whether it is English, any language you need rock foundation. Foundation is very important because building the how deep you dig and make that building, put the iron, steel, everything, that building will become problem. So also with the language. So this is like your grammar, the only language is like a foundation. So if you want to become like master in English language, if you want to become master in Marathi language or in Hindi, you need to know grammar. That is why we learn grammar. And basic grammar is very, very important. All of you know alphabets, no? How many are there? 5 hours and
21 consonants.
21 consonants. Good. So these are alphabets. These are like a beat. Now we want to make a mala, then beat one by one we have to make, no?
Yes.
So these alphabets are joined into what we make? This alphabet. Now alphabet A or B or C, D, these are all alphabets. These are all alphabets. All 26 are called alphabet. 5 are called vowels. 21 are called consonants. This is understandable because this is the first standard KG class children will learn. Now, you all are 5th standard. Now, with this alphabet, what we make, how we speak, what we use?
English.
I am asking to communicate what we use. So what is that called? Word. See, that means you all did not understand whatever we missed to the 6th lesson. But what is important? This alphabet to communicate, to talk. When I am talking, you are understanding because you know the word. Any language, whether it is Hindi, whether it is Marathi, whether it is English, any language, Italian, German, Japanese, anything you take, you need words. Now take Marathi. Suppose you don't know what is jahaj. If you don't know, if I don't know jahaj in Marathi means tree, then I will not understand. Isn't it? So also with English, any language, we communicate with, we talk to each other with
Word.
Then, from words forms the
sentence.
Very good. From words we form the sentence. So, if I am saying, I am teaching English. So, what happens to that? It's a sentence. Now, I say, suppose somebody asks, who is teaching your English? Who is that? Who is teaching your English? Sister. You will say sister. Now suppose you say only sister. English is taught by sister. Suppose you want to say in whole sentence. Now you are only saying to say teaching. No, only you are saying to say teaching. To say teaching what? Because they already asked you who is teaching you English. Isn't it? So to say teaching. That also is a sentence. Now, for example, I would say, now, Meher, you brought the book. Did you? So, what I am asking, did you mean? Did you brought? given in the book. So what is it? Half some, you can understand. It makes not complete sense. Those are called a
phrase.
So we have word forms the
sentence.
If this phrase is a part of the sentence, this will give you complete sense. Complete sense. Short form. It gives you some sense, but it will not give you complete sense. So in a sentence, we have subject and predicate with source. There is a, now suppose I say, what is your name? Akshara is sitting in front. It's a sentence. She is sitting. It is sentence, but it is phrase when we say. She wore, now Akshara wore red and black in color. Her dress is red and black in color. Now I say red and black. Red and black, if I only use that, it becomes a phrase. If I say Akshara wore or her dress color is the red and black, then it becomes a sentence. So part of the sentence, it makes some sense, it is called phrase. But if it is a full sentence or full meaning is conveyed to us, it becomes a sentence. So sentence and phrase. You understood this too?
Yes.
That is the first, no? What you have in the first? Okay, sentence and the phrase. That is the first chapter. Now, this all you all did. Page number 3. Page 3. 3. So, what you must do? You must just go like this. These are such a small creature. Tiny creature. See, now first, third, I am only going by now the titles, the only the understanding part, because you already did all this. You have followed this, no?
Yeah.
How many of you, see, some of you have not completed, some of you have completed. Those of you have not given me the book, what is your name?
Janvi.
Janvi, you don't have book. You have at home?
Yes.
Okay. So, every day you will have English and Math and? English, Math and?
Science.
Yes. Then, alternate few days you will have Marathi. Then you will have Hindi. Then you have EVS 1 and EVS 2. Because that is important. Feeling, learning, all want to stand up. Just stand. For a minute, keep the book down. Keep the book down. Stand. Stand. Nicely. Right? All the laziness, remove that. Make like this. Just jump. And flat hands now. Then this side. Then turn round. All our sleepiness is gone. Do like this. Do like this. This side. Okay. Then sleeping like this. This is like this. And this turns like this. Then just the snap. See, let us increase the louder. Then open your fingers. Open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close. Up, 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 up. Like that. Both hands. Up. Very good. Both the hands. Up. Then just one third. Nicely, one third. Then sit. How are you feeling now?
Nice, no?
Okay. Then at least just smile, nicely. Ha 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 ha. body gets the energy. I can understand because you all were sitting, no? After that you all did not get up. I understand. So now we fall to subject and predicate. This is the first part of the sentence. Now, we had a short exercise. I'm just telling you, we had a short exercise. Isn't it? Now you all did like this, no? Isn't it? So we had a short exercise. In that sentence, now suppose I write here, we had a short, speaking about now subject and predicate. So subjects are who? No. What is written in this sentence?
We.
Very good. So here this is the subject. Isn't it? We are talking in this sentence. We are we. We. And here there is a, this is what?
Had
means? It is, I want to ask you whether it is verb, whether it is act. You have learned adjective and all, no?
Yes.
Last year?
Yes.
Remember?
Yes.
Oh, you said, Sister Connie taught, but we have forgotten. Huh? Isn't it? Nice smile you all will give me and you will say, it is forgotten, sister. But we can revise all this. We had, this is a verb. That means we all did, no?
Yes.
Isn't it? So we had a short exercise. We had what?
It's a subject.
Ah, that is the subject. Had a short exercise is the predicate. Predicate. The first part about whom it is spoken, that is the subject, and about what it is spoken, it becomes a predicate.
Both of you are talking.
The students are green. Three branches are brown. So these are statements. The sun is hot. We are waiting for rain. All statements. They are called. What are the sentences? No, what type of sentence that is
assertive.
So statement, anything says, the fifth standard students are seated on the mat, behind or under the tree. So what that sentence is also a statement. Whenever we use statement, that means we communicate as well as we give a statement. That is called the assertive sentence. Assertive sentence. What are they called?
Assertive
sentence. Repeat.
Assertive.
What is the spelling of assertive?
A-S-S-E-R-T-I-V-E.
What is the spelling of assertive?
A-S-S-E-R-T-I-V-E.
Then know your name? Siddharth. What is the spelling of assertive? Look and tell me in the book. Which page we are talking about? Page?
I know.
No, I want Siddharth to tell me. What is the page?
Kinds of.
Kinds of? Sentence. That word you said, sentence. Kinds of sentence. And we are talking about the assertive. That's the first type of sentence. All your textbooks, if you open, many assertive sentences you will find. Now, the second category of sentence is called imperative sentence. What is that?
Imperative sentence.
Ajit? Can I go out? Will you help me, Purva? May I come in? Can I drink water? I feel happy. Can you join me celebrating the birthday?
Yes.
So what happens this type of sentences are? What are they? What type of sentence did I ask you now? Oh, when I spoke to imperative sentence. Imperative sentences will have request and command. Keep quiet. Stand up. Do the exercise. Sit down. Get out. All these are command. Close the door. So anything request or command. Stop talking. What type of sentence?
Imperative
sentence. So imperative sentences will always have request. May I? Will you? Shall? Or let it be? Let the children be there. So all these requests or commands will come under imperative sentence. What type of sentence?
Imperative sentence.
The statements are called. Statements are called
assertive.
Or command or request type of sentence is called
imperative.
Then only you can understand. Now we have the third type of question. What is your name? Who are you? Who is your father? When did you join the school? Where are you staying? What time the school will be? What time we will get the thingy?
A question we ask.
What? I am questioning, no?
Yes.
When, what, who, whose, when, all the walk. All the walk, where, alphabet. What, how, why, when, what. All these question words are use that type of sentence is called. What type of
sentence?
Interrogative sentence. No.
Interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence.
What is the word?
Interrogative sentence.
Sentence will always end with mark, exclamatory mark. This you must keep in mind. Two things, imperative and assertive, will end with
full stop.
Interrogative sentence will end with exclamatory sentence will end with exclamatory mark. So, these kinds of sentences, if you understood, this much you have one. Because any type of sentence you take, they all fall in these four categories. Those four categories are, now we are going to write that spelling on the board.